In this video, we're going to talk about Backstage. Imagine a big toolbox where you can keep all your software tools neatly organized. Think of it as the magical toy box for technology professionals, helping them find what they need so they can do their work and build amazing things. Backstage.io is an open source platform built to help developers and organizations manage their internal software tools, services, and components. It offers a unified dashboard where you can view and control everything. This centralized interface simplifies workflow and streamlines processes across the organization. So why do we need Backstage? Companies often use a wide array of different software tools and services. Managing all of these tools can become a complex and time-consuming task. Backstage.io provides a single space where everyone can see what tools are available, who's using them, and how to access them. This greatly improves efficiency and simplifies work processes. Let's examine some of the key features of Backstage. Number one, unified dashboard. Backstage offers a unified dashboard that acts as a one-stop shop for all services, tools, and data. You can manage, monitor, and find everything from this centralized interface. The second feature is Service Catalog. The Service Catalog acts like an internal marketplace for all your software tools and services. It provides visibility into what services exist, how they are connected, and who owns them. The third feature we'll examine is the software templates. Templates allow you to quickly create new services or components. They are pre-configured settings and code structures that help to streamline the development process. The fourth feature is Tech Docs. Tech Docs serve as the inbuilt documentation engine. They allow you to create, store, and share documentation right within Backstage.io, making it easier to maintain up-to-date information. Finally, plugins. Plugins are extensions that you can add to Backstage to enhance its functionality. This modular system allows you to customize the platform to suit the specific needs of your organization. To conclude, Backstage is an incredibly useful tool for organizations looking to streamline their software management process. Its unified dashboard, service catalog, software templates, tech docs, and plugins make it an all-encompassing platform for software management and development. If you like this content and would like to learn more about platform engineering, then subscribe to TechInAid Academy at techinaid.com. You're going to learn through courses, labs, and playgrounds. Now let's take a look at a demo of Backstage. Now I've set this up before in a previous video, so you can check that out above here. Now, as you can see, we have our homepage, my company catalog, and here you're going to have all the software components or services at your company. You can see how many are owned by you or by your team. So you have some filters on the side here. So this example website, as you can see, it's part of a system called examples. The owner is guests. It's of type website. Lifecycle is experimental, so it's not production. So if you click in here, you can see some of the relations that we have here. So this component example website, the owner is the group guests, and system examples is part of this component, or this component is part of the system. So you can see the relation goes back and forth. And also it provides this API, example GRC API. So this component provides this API, or this API is provided by this component. We can see here if there are any subcomponents, and we can put some links to external dashboards or services here as well if you need to. This can be a link to your source code, so your GitHub, and also link to tech docs. There are also multiple tabs here. We'll investigate these in some other videos, but just know that we can take a look at the pipeline, dependencies, and the tech docs which show up here. You can also take a look at some of the APIs that you might have, and we saw this example gRPC API. Again, system is examples, owner is guests, it's of type gRPC, it's experimental. If you click here, once again, you'll see the relationships. And once again, API example gRPC is provided by the component example website, who the owner is, part of what system, and so on. You can see the providers, consumers, and so on, right? So everything in one place, so you don't go looking for dependencies and your software components in multiple places. You can see the definition of the gRPC API here as well. Now, one thing I really like about Backstage is the templates capability. So here you can put some guardrails in place and governance for your developers as they create a new service, for example. In this case, we have a service for a Node.js app. So you can see an example template for the scaffolder that creates a simple Node.js service, who the owner is and so on. You can choose that as a developer. And here you can give that a name. So let's call it My Node App Demo 2, for example. And next step, then you can put in your owner, your GitHub owner, and I've attached or linked my GitHub account to Backstage. And then a repository, which is the same name as the name I put here for our example Node.js app. Next step, you can go ahead and check to review everything looks good and create. This is going to go ahead and publish and register this component with our catalog. And we can take a look and see what happened here. You can see our GitHub repo got created over here, right here. And in that repo, we have three files. Of course, this is all configurable. And here's the catalog that registers this component with our Backstage catalog, as you can see here. We have index.js, we've got package.json, all of that was configured within our application. As a platform engineer, you're the one who would configure this, and the developer would just choose that from the catalog or the service catalog, and they'll end up with this repo. So once again, you can create these guardrails for your developers. And not only that, but you can spin up some pipelines that can go out and create an environment, let's say in Google GCP, maybe spin up a Kubernetes cluster for your developers to deploy their application for testing on it and get that all ready for them, and come back with some URL or credentials for deploying the app there. So it makes the life of the developer a lot easier, as we mentioned before. And really, this is a quick demo to show you what it looks like. In following videos, we're going to dig a little bit deeper into each one of the components that we mentioned in this video. So the software catalog that we just saw, the tech docs, we'll take a look at the templates and how we can use CI/CD pipelines in conjunction with the templates. I'm really excited about that functionality and see how that works. And plugins, of course, and much more. So stay tuned, and thank you for watching.